So in the Geostar 2011, we had about 50 places for participants, which were from research in the field of geosciences and students, PhD students, and also younger researchers, postdocs. We had participants from all continents except from Antarctica, but many people cannot attend. We had about twice the number of applications for a course, participation than we could offer places. And due to time limitations, many people would also not attend. And finally, there are parallel sessions. So that means that even that all participants from the course would miss out on other sessions during the course. Finally, of course, there are costs. You have to travel to a location where Geostar takes place, and you have to pay some course fees. So broadcasting allows you to participate without actually going there, which is the same as this virtual conference that we have here, where you can participate without coming to the conference. And it allows you to later educate yourself and teach you these free open source software tools at another time, and so be some kind of virtual participant. So I'm briefly explaining the technical setup. We had in all presentations a presenter notebook that is connected to streaming notebook, which actually records all the slides, and at the same time gets from the webcam a signal, a picture of or from the presentation room, from the room where the presentation was held, so that viewers have an idea of how the presentation was given and about the presenter. And finally, there's a wireless microphone attached to the notebook, so that the presenter gets broadcasting to the streaming notebook for the audio signal. The connection was done between the presenter notebook and the streaming notebook with the software TeamView, which is free but not open source, but it's freely available for academic institutions. You also needed we needed a second screen, and this was needed to merge the slides that were broadcasted that were submitted from TeamView with the picture that we obtained with the webcam. So to merge these two, we needed a second screen. So on this second screen, we recorded the webcam picture and the slides, and of course the audio signal. And this was done with the free software Adobe Flash Media Live Encoder. And we streamed this to Ustream, which is a streaming website relatively popular with many streams that are all for free. And we did this live streaming there. But at the same time, we recorded, of course, all the sessions, and we archived it. And the Internet Archive, which is a non-profit project where text, audio, or media files are archived, and which allows free access to them from anywhere in the world. So have a quick look how this looks like. So you have the archive.org, and we have a quick look in one of the videos. So you can make a full screen. So far, for giving you an idea of how these presentations looks like, and you see that on this website, you can play and download all these videos. Note that the audio quality that you just heard was not very good, but this is just due to playing the video on the website. If you download the video to your local computer, the audio quality would be much better. So all these videos were uploaded to archive, and you can access them now in the archive. If you search for GeoStart, you will find all related videos. We actually have created websites where we have the links to all videos so that you can have a short outline and a short description of what is in the video, and also additional material. So we have not only the videos but the scripts, the software links and literature on this GeoStart course website and on the website of our university. So we can quickly have a look there. Here you will see the program of each day, and you have the links here and some content in the for the different video days. So the data files I put in one folder, and you can be downloaded here as well. You will find more information as well on the GeoStart website. So in terms of evaluation, there was a high demand for the streams and videos. We had more than 1,350 followers of live streams. That was since 2011. So there were about 200 to 600 downloads of each of the GeoStart videos that we put on the archive.org, and there were additional downloads from the websites of the University Koblenz-Landau and GeoStart website, but we had no counters there, so I cannot tell you how many downloads there were. But nevertheless, I think this shows you that there is quite some interest in this educational content. In addition, I received very positive feedback via email and from participants directly of having access to these videos. So generally, I would sum up that this broadcasting, which could be done relatively easy, is a big success story, or was a big success story. And generally, we see that educational content becomes more and more widely available. For example, you have the OpenCast project or the iTunes University, iTunes U, where you can watch different podcasts and screencasts from lectures and so on. You also have this, as mentioned in the introduction to this talk, for free open source software, but it's relatively scattered over different social media platforms, but also on different websites related to the respective free open software project. You have YouTube, you will find many, for example, for QuantumJS or GrassJS or R introductions, but you have them as well on the website of GrassJS. So I would pose the question whether it would make sense to have some kind of specialized repository for free open source software educational content, something like iTunes University or OpenCast, where you know that for all these many existing free open source software project for spatial analysis that you can find educational content, since as mentioned in introduction, coverage by textbooks is relatively limited. So hopefully the GeoStart 2012 meeting will also broadcast and gives more experiences on, and perhaps improvements on, how to achieve this broadcasting and make available introductions to the software to everybody worldwide. So I thank you for your attention, all GeoStart lecturers, for giving this GeoStart course that we recorded, and of course all people working on free open source software, all these contributors and enthusiasts that really lead to a huge availability of software that allows to tackle almost any analysis you want to do and with geographical data. So I also thank, of course, the local helpers of Geostat 2011, as well as PhD students or staff members from the University Koblenz-Landau. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to contact me. You have also, you can visit our websites for more information on our research, which is related to climate change, land use and toxicants mainly, and their effects on freshwater biodiversity and ecosystem functioning. And I'm looking forward to your questions in the flash meeting after this talk now. Thank you very much.